Hello. Somewhere while making the 9-volt USB rechargeable battery of my previous video, I managed to kill the boost converter. All of a sudden it would no longer boost the provided voltage. I marked the damaged module and performed some tests. The module doesn't output the required voltage, and the NT3608 chip on the damaged module gets very hot. As you can see here, it now draws a high current even when no load is connected. Measuring the resistance between Vin and ground on the faulty module shows a very low resistance. On the brand new module, the resistance between those inputs is much higher. The block diagram in the datasheet shows there is an internal MOSFET between the switch pin and ground via a current sensing resistor. As shown in this application circuit, the switch pin is connected to Vin via the inductor. Both an inductor as a sensing resistor normally have low resistance, but a MOSFET that is switched off should have a very high resistance. As MOSFETs are known to be sensitive to static electricity, maybe my faulty handling released some magic smoke and now it seems to be shorting out. Because I don't like throwing things away, I wanted to try to repair the module by replacing the chip. These chips can be ordered for quite low prices. I bought 20 chips for less than 10 euro cents each via AliExpress. In the outro of Great Scott's last video about the TP5410 LiPo charger and boost converter, he showed what effect a too high voltage or current can have on electronics. I was eager to know if applying high currents can also be used on purpose to easily desolder faulty SMD components. My first attempt was simply letting the chip get very hot again. While the chip got hot enough, not all pins came loose. Using additional solder and the solder iron, I was able to pry off the old chip. I then placed a new chip on the board and soldered the legs. After inspecting the solder joints, I tested the repaired boost converter and checked it by adjusting the output voltage to power this ESP8266 module. As you can see, it now seems to work again. So I hope you liked this video. Thank you for viewing. If you liked this video, you can subscribe to be notified of future videos. Bye!